context, doesn't it? Because if you're traveling by water, and you want to have access to a place like this, that'd be sort of a place that you would set off from.
Absolutely, and the fact that the town of Trempealeau has Trempealeau Mountain, which is how it gets its name, the mountain that dips its feet in the river. That is one of, if not the most geologically distinct landmarks on the entire Mississippi River. The fact that that marks the gateway from the Mississippi River up the Trempealeau River to this, what is it, I think the South Fork of the Trempealeau River that's just below us here, that's a direct road to this place from most of the rest of North America. And it made it a relatively easy place to find. I believe that the majority of people coming and going from here did so by foot. I'm very willing to bet, though, that people coming to here from Cahokia during Mississippian times, that they probably walked here by foot, but that while people were here mining, there were also people here building dugout canoes, which they'd load up with, my best guess is that they'd load it up with Hixton silicified sandstone, and that they were probably also utilizing the very dense deer population that had existed here in Wisconsin, much denser than other contiguous portions of this part of North America. But they were utilizing that. They were coming back with wild rice and all kinds of stuff that might not have been as easily obtainable in the resource-starved locality of Cahokia. After they had, 10,000, 20,000 or more people living in that really dense area, I think that they had no choice but to reach out and start drawing more resources in from the hinterlands, if you will, and that this was one of the key sites that they really focused on.